there are conditions. Do not worry, okay? For this is the second part of the process, okay? So the title is, you are a great person. Say I am great.
I am great.
Say I am a great person.
I am a great person.
Look at your neighbor and say you are a great person. So listen to me very well. The fact that you are driving does not mean that you are great. The fact that you don't have a house does not mean that you are great. The fact that you don't wear any spending from does not mean that you're great. The fact that you don't have millions in your bank account does not mean that you're a great person. Greatness is in God. It's God who makes people great. When God spoke to Abraham, he says to Abraham, I shall make you great, and I shall make your name great. It is God that gives greatness. So greatness comes from God. So there is no way yourself and yourself we can be great people. I am here, I've come here to prophesy in your life that my son, my daughter, you are a great person. However, greatness comes by a process. Say process. If you want to do something big, if you want to do something great, there is a process. And the process is a great process. For something great, there is a great process. For something big, there is a big process. So greatness comes by great process. Say process. So our challenge of today's church, today's church people, they've taken process from everything. We are a church now, we are in a generation now, they tell you now, no problem for you to pray. We can pray for you. I am a powerful man of God. Your papa sees everything. And they take away prayer from you. We are now in the season of grace. If you sin, we are forgiven. Now no more condemnation in Christ. We are all sinners. Jesus Christ, help. And they don't tell you that he does not want you to remain in sin, to commit sin. They have not taken the gospel of righteousness away from your soul, of which means God establishes the righteous. Say neighbor, God establishes the righteous. It's also important to understand it, know where the word is coming from. What the Bible, they say there's a man in the Bible called Samuel. Whatever he saw by his mouth, he said by his mouth, it never fell down. There are some people that God has respected. When they speak, it will come to pass. So by virtue of myself declaring in your life that you are great, it will stand. No matter where it's going to come after me, your mother, your uncle, your auntie, your friends, at work in the government, your neighbor, when they come to come to tell you, it is not going to work, because I have told you today that you are great. Whoever is going to come after me and tell you that they are not great, it will not work in the name of Jesus. I decree and I prophesy in the name of Jesus Christ that you are great in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, kings rules by decrees. In the book of John 2:28, God says what you see that you want, make a decree, and I will establish it. I've come to make a declaration upon your life. I've come to decree upon your life that you are a great woman of God. You are a great man of God. You are great. I don't care if some of us they are talking anything about you. I don't care who prophesied that you're not going to be married. I don't care who prophesied that you're not going to make money. I also here come with the anointing upon my head to prophesy to your life that you are going to make money, that you are going to have a good job, that you are going to have a beautiful marriage, that you are going to prosper, you are going to take the job, you are going to make it, you are great, you are going to prosper in the name of Jesus. I have come to prophesy, I have come to declare in the name of Jesus that you are great in Jesus. Starting from last week, we'll be talking about cases. Taking cases out. Amen. I love when we are talking about tithes. Tithes is an automatic case that we cannot even bless ourselves. It's you who makes up what that case. Amen. I can't pray to bless the case of tithe. You tithe to bless it. So that one is so great. Amen. I don't see anything difficult. Because the job that you have is your God. The man that you receive is from God. So to give him 10%, I don't think it's something that is very difficult. I want to see this year. This year is going to happen in this year. I have said it in my view. You know, you see, I've been here. It's them, road and road. Sometimes they come, sometimes they don't come. You see? Isaiah 53, verse 1. Isaiah 53. Isaiah 53. Who has believed our report? And to whom is the arm of the Lord given? For ye shall grow before ye make the tender plant. And there is a root out of the dragon. Ye have no form of countenance. And when we shall see, there is no beauty that we should desire. He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief, and we hide as it were our faces from him. He was despised and mistreated not. Look here. He was despised and received not. Which is what? Jesus. Isaiah was prophesied the country of Jesus Christ as well. And when Jesus comes, people, they rejected him, they despised him. That's why it means that the corner which the builders, they rejected. The stone that people, the builders, they rejected, they become the chief cornerstone. Which means Christ was what? Rejected when he came to the world. Hear me very well. Why am I calling that scripture? God himself, he came to this world. And men failed to esteem him. But yet men despise God. The fact that you think that you are not great is because people they are despising you. It's because people they are looking down upon you. You look at nothing. But I want you to understand the world's standards. That as the world sees you, also God they have seen him the same way. even if you are God. So you don't need to worry about how people despise you, how people look upon you. They have to despise you. Why? It is the habit of God. There are some things that God will never repay. Say, God will never repay. No matter you say, we are now the generation, the modern generation. No matter you say, we are now the this generation. God is not going to change his code. Listen to me. It is the habit of God. When he makes something very great and nice, after making it, he hides it. He conceals it, and he hides it, and he gives it to the world. And you will never see, and you will never realize it, because it will be hidden. That's how God had made men in this world. Some people that are afraid, that's not demons. The demon will say, this one, I have taken out their car. And you ask the person, have you ever given? They say no. They have never given. But cars already have been taken. Because God has hidden things into his people. God, whatever he wants, and whatever he makes good, he hides it from the eyes of the people. Do you know why God hides it from the eyes of the people? So that it's not destroyed before its time. So that he can process you. So that he can review you to the world when you are ready to stand for yourself. When no man can destroy you now, that's when he reviews you. I was telling people, I said, grace, greater grace in this world is to see the grace of God before some people see it. I would like to believe in the Bible. A man who was blessed is Nathan. Nathan was able to see David before anyone and make a covenant with David before anyone. The challenge today we have, people, they wait for everyone to bloom and they start to go to that person. That is not grace. Grace is for you to be able to see someone when they are still young, that they are a great person in you. Great people, my pastor, great people, great pastors, they are there right now. They are not even driving any car. They are just smoking right now. They are wearing suits for 200, 300. When they see you, they say, ah, this one, this one. But they are great. It's because God has hidden something into them. They are processing it. I have come here to tell somebody, although you don't have a car right now, although you are driving, although you don't have a good job right now, although you are still working, although you don't have a big house right now, I am saying you are great, but God wants to process you. 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 I am always happy when I am at a place and I see people despising me and I see people looking down upon me. I know God is still covering me. I know God is still with me because himself was despised. So being despised by people does not mean that you are not great. Because what is causing people to despise you? They are looking that you don't have a car. They are looking that your dress is cheap. They are looking that your suit is cheap. They are looking that you don't have a business. But that does not stop God from making you great. Because you were made great and you are a great man. I do not read so many scriptures because of my time. But I will narrate some of the things. Look when God called Moses. Moses said, why me? I stand. Moses was in a bush, gathering sheep. He was nothing and nothing. He himself, he could see himself not fit. He thought that the people are fit. But God said, you, Moses, I'm going to use you to deliver this. Even himself, not believe it. Because he knew that he was good. Look at Gideon. When God called Gideon, he said, God, you cannot call me your big brother's name, not in our family, but God said you did it. So, ladies and gentlemen, those that are despised, God uses that. You are despised because God wants to use you. You are despised because God wants to use you. Because God uses what human, what man despises. So don't worry about what people are saying to you. Don't worry about what people are saying to you. God is allowing it so that he can use you. Let us go to 1 Samuel 6. We are going to read this one. Other than keep the scripture. 1 Samuel 16. Verse 6. 1 Samuel 16, verse 6. And it came to pass when they were come, that he looked on Eliab and said, surely the Lord's anointing is before you. But the Lord said unto Samuel, look not on his countenance, or on the height of his stature, because I have refused him. For the Lord seeth not as men see. For men look on the outward appearance, but the Lord looketh on the heart. God has refused. I don't see as men, but I see as God. Not outward, but I look inward. I look in the heart. That's where I am. They were Aminadab. They were other great sons there, but they were not anointed. The person that was despised was David. He was not even there. They said, is there anyone here if you want to live? They said, yes, but the son who is going to sheep. Then they said, let us take that one. David came. He was despised. But yet it was God's chosen. Despised by men, but God's chosen. Ladies and gentlemen, it's nothing in this world to be despised by men. It's nothing in this world to be despised by men. Because men cannot lift you. Men cannot make you great. When men despise you, don't look down upon yourself. But glory from God is a glory that is unique. So now, listen to me. We now have the notes here. That is the scripture that I read with you, but all the notes. Say notes. Manual is given. God is the one who makes people great. Eh? Then his manual, he made it great to everyone. I don't look outward. I don't look how you look. I don't look how you dress. I don't look the cars you have. I don't look your house. But I look at your heart. So a wise person, you will start to work towards your heart. Because God does not look at anything, but he looks inside what? So the real fight and the real battle that we have in Christians is to make our heart right with God. This is the man. So if one wants to make you great, to rise, our battle that we have right now as Christians, it's one battle, say one battle to become great. One battle to become great. God looks at your heart. I have chosen David. I did not look at yourself, but I look at the heart. The problem with church today, they are busy looking at certain things. Things that are not worthy. Things that don't gain any value. But when God is looking at you, he's looking at your heart. Say neighbor, when God is looking at you, he's looking at your heart. Last week I was talking about blessed people. I said blessed people are the people who have pure heart. your heart must be given to God. The first thing that Christians must do is to give their heart to God. Love your God with all your heart, with all your spirit. That is the first and biggest commandment, to love your God with all your heart. Because if you give your heart to God, He will make your heart right. But the challenge churches now, we never gave our heart to God. You have given your heart to money, and the money is destroying your heart. Because when you love money too much, the money will destroy your heart. Well, there are men outside there that will tell you that we can sleep with you and we can promote you. We can sleep with you and buy you a nice house. It's because of where you have put your heart. But when you give your heart to God, He will make your heart right. And when you make your heart right, He will make you great. But this world, people, they are busy giving their heart to the things of this world. We have given heart to the pleasure of this world. And in the process, we have become with a heart that is full of jealousy, a heart that is full of envy, a heart that is fighting other people, and an evil heart. I have come to tell somebody today that your heart belongs to Jesus Christ. Your heart belongs to God. I want you to say, God, I give my heart to yourself. Make my heart right with you. But when I'm preaching Jesus like Christ like this, I can help 10 viewers and no one will view. People, they skip. Everyone is looking for nonsense to view. So every man now is in his own things and in his own pleasures. So no one is no longer patient to be processed by God, to be persevered with God. Everyone is now running away from process. No one wants to pray. No one wants to do things right. No one wants to be chastened by God. No one wants to be called by God. Everyone is in shortcuts. Everyone is busy with this thing. But I'm saying to you, my son and daughter, allow process. Say process. Greatness comes by the process. So you need to allow God to process you. Can I tell you something? When God chose Saul was the first king of Israel. It was there out of them divided to go that one king. When you chose Saul to be king, there was no process. Say no process. And Saul was taken to be king. God said He chose Saul because Saul had shoulders that were above every man's shoulder. And he was looking handsome. That was the qualification. He looked outward. And he chose Saul. Do you know that? And after he looked outward, Saul has become king. There was no process. But Saul could not last with the kingship because of disobedience. Then God regretted making Saul a king. Then he chose David, who went process. Which process did David went? David went process through the sheep. And David was looking after sheep. He was killing the bear. He was killing the lion that was coming to fight his sheep. He went through process, and then he chose David. And David, he did well because he went through what? Process. Joseph, he went through process. Every man of God in the Bible, they went through process. So you must walk through process. Labor, process is not going to destroy you, but the process is going to mount you. It's not going to break you, but it's going to make you strong. It's going to make you stand. It's going to make you right with God. Process is needed for every blessed man and every blessed woman. You must go through process. Say process never.
The time is up. Let me just say.
Number two. No season in time. No season in time. No season in time. It is written in the Bible. It's not yet a surprise that everyone is watching London on Facebook. Everyone is following London on WhatsApp. It's not yet a surprise. It was written in the Bible. In the last days, men shall be lovers of themselves. Men shall be lovers of money. Men saw our season in time that we have. We are in those seasons where you go on Facebook, everyone is putting my story. This is not my story. You put yourself with all the makeup, with all nice dresses. You put those shines. Look at my profile picture. I'm wearing my suit with my wife. Everyone is showing themselves. How they look nice, how they look their face. Everyone, they are showing off on Facebook how they make money, how they are rich. Someone come and say, I've got these cars, I've got this. Knowing seasons and times. You can be blessed when you know seasons and times. We are in the last day where every man and every woman is a lover of themselves. Right now, even yourself, when you go to Facebook, what are you going to do? You are going that your story. What are you eating there? Yourself and your face. You are showing the world that you are beautiful. Loving yourself. Your apostle is boss. Says, showing what? I'm smart. I'm with the white jacket. Loving ourselves. Men shall be lovers of themselves. Lovers of money. We are in the last days. This is the season that we are. Every man is posting about themselves, showing how nice they are. Every man is looking after themselves. We are in the last days. So when you know these are the days that men does not love God, but they are lovers of themselves, you can post and add to your story without sharing the Spirit of Grace page, without sharing Jesus Christ, even to post a scripture, you can't. Love us of ourselves. So no seasons, and do what is right for God. Don't do things because everyone is doing it. Even men of God nowadays, they are coming out, this is my church, this is my heart, am I sure I can do this? Everyone is showing you. Everyone is showing you. It's the last day. Amen. So this is first, was there in the Bible. Number three, always know that God does not see as men see. Stop seeing things as God as people see. Stop seeing things as people see. See things as God sees things. Don't do things because many people are doing. Everyone is doing. God does not see like people. You must be grounded in the word. Allow the Holy Spirit to lead you, because you might see wrong. You don't see as God sees. So allow the Spirit of get noted. Yeah. If you try to comment those men of God who are coming on Facebook with their drink beer, you try to comment them, yeah? They will eat you. We are all sinners. Hey, are you now a judge? Hey, we are all. It's like the world is understanding everything, you know? Hey, we look at it. We are people, we are basically looking at other people's weaknesses. We must encourage each other. We must leave these weaknesses. It's like now the world is people who are with love more than God. They love people more than God now. And they understand people more than God now. You can't comment them. The world has approved nothing. You know why they are doing it? Because when someone is doing something wrong, and he cannot do it, and people are used to it, it becomes normal. You will stop seeing it as a sin. You will stop disregarding it. That's why it stops on TV. Their TVs now soaps. They are putting people in fornication, slowly but surely. Because we are seeing every people. I always say to you, if you look generation, you look Rhythm City, you look Scandal, you look Mzanzi, whatever, Queen, by you know the night you are going to sleep, you have seen 80 cases in your head. Watching the television, my daughter, our television, our soaps and the few people are watching, even our children. Per night, per day, it's more than 80 cases you see on television. And after watching those cases, you are going to sleep. Tomorrow you are going to watch 90. And what is happening? Because we are seeing it every day. So what is happening? Men lose control. It becomes normal. What they are saying to everything. I have told you that whenever you see these things, after you want to pray, take 1 hour of prayer. Yeah, my son, if you see 40 kisses, when you enter any prayer, you say, I cancel one, kiss number one. I cancel kiss number two. I cancel kiss number three. I cancel, you must cancel all the kisses. If you don't cancel them, they will say you do things that are not right. So the world wants us to be understanding to that thing, so that ourselves we will see them that it's good to do. But right, they are not right with God. We normalize bad things. Never normalize bad things. They are not normal with God. They are not normal. Number four, be ready to battle. No devil strategies. Be ready to fight. If you want to be a great man, Christianity is not for the weak. Yeah, I have gone to church, nothing is wrong. Yeah, Christianity is battle, it is fight after fight. You must fight, you must stand and pray, you must fight and pray. This is not moving, this is the word of God. He said to David, I'll give you my daughter, not because he wanted to give me a wife, But he said, if I give him my daughter, we trap him with my daughter. Amen. And we'll kill him. So you need to be very careful now in this battle, spiritual battle. There are some things that you love too much. Please be careful with them. Not all breakthroughs and open doors are your open doors. Some things you love them too much. The devil used that one to get you. Samson never had his weakness with Delilah, with women. He was given Delilah and he was met before. So Christians need to be vigilant.
Say it, be vigilant.
Number 5, be patient.